H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
For long data type, for long data type it is 8 bytes. Okay, so I got a question saying, like, if we declare a long for saving marks, will the system not automatically manage memory, like releasing the memory? So yeah, it will release the memory once the use of variable is done, but it will allocate 8 bytes for that variable, which is not required. Okay, so I'll explain again when we are discussing value types and reference types. For now, keep it in mind, like, depending on the size of the number, you have to use appropriate data type. So yeah, okay, so now what we'll do is okay, so let's go back to the PDF. Okay, so now let me open Visual Studio. So we don't need Visual Studio, but let me open it. I would recommend to work on using Notepad itself for today's assignment as well. Okay, I'll not be opening Visual Studio for now. I'll open in the next class. So now we have something called system type. System type is something like the alias name for either you can use sbyte, or you can also use these. For example, for short data type, you can also use int 16. So let me open Windows R Notepad. So I'll quickly type one short program and I'll compile it. For those who missed yesterday's class, see how to compile this using Notepad. Okay, so using system class numbers or whatever, and all I need to do is I need to write here public static void main, and after this I need to write here int. I'm just storing int a is equal to 5. Now I'm just writing console dot write line a. So this is how you write it in. You write in C programming, I mean C sharp. Console.write line, you have to give a. Okay. So if you recollect your C programming, in C program we write like this. Printf. You will not write like this. So in C programming you will write like this. %d, comma a. So this is how you write in C programming. So in C sharp there are many ways to do. One way is you can directly write the variable name, and the other way to do that is you can write like this console dot write line. You can also do like this. You can write in flower brackets and then zero and then comma a. You can write like this. So that means this zero will be replaced with this a. So normally when you have many values to be printed, in that case we'll use 0, 1, 2, 3, and after comma you write A, B, C like this. Okay, I'll explain this again, don't worry. And the other way to do is you can simply write, okay, for now keep this in mind, this is how you normally write it, or you can also use this way to write it. Okay, so I'll explain this again. So now I'll remove this. Just a second. Okay, so am I going a bit faster, or you want me to go slowly? Please tell me so that Okay, so now I have written a simple class using system, class numbers, and so the initial five classes, you might feel like we are going a bit slow or a bit faster. So for that reason, just to bring you up to the speed, we are sharing these videos with you. So even after the class, you can go through the videos and try to get up to the mark, up to the speed, and then you will be definitely comfortable with the classes. Okay. So what I have written is, I have just written simple C# program. So now I'll compile it. So what I'll do is, I will save it. I wrote using system, class numbers, public static void main, and I just declared a variable int a is equal to 5, and I wrote console.writeline. Yeah, okay. So now let me save it. I'll save it inside this d:h2k. I'll save it as numbers.cs. So what I'll do here, I'll save it as numbers.cs. I'm just giving in double quotes. Click on save. Now, how to compile this program is, I need to open command prompt, Windows R CMD, and then I just open command prompt, and then let me see whether the file is saved or not. So my computer, d:, inside this folder I saved it. I saved as numbers.cs. So now let me compile it. So all I need to do to compile is, where is my compiler, CSE? I don't want to type CSE here. I want to give the full path. So either I can give CSE or I can give the full path also. So can you help me where I have that CSE.exe? For those who attended yesterday class, yeah, where is that folder? I want the complete path of the folder. No, I want to know the folder where I have CSE.exe file. I mean, we saw three compilers, right? In which folder we saw the three compilers? No. Yeah, so I got one response. Yeah, correct. So from where I got that is, I just opened my computer. I need to go to C:. I need to go to Windows. I need to go to Microsoft.net. And then framework version 4.0. Here I have CSE. So what I can do is, I can copy this path. Yeah, I can copy this path. And then what I can do is, I can paste this path /CSE space. I can give space and give numbers.cs. What I'm doing is, in this path, I have my CSE C# compiler, and I'm giving numbers.cs. okay, so if I press enter in this folder, if you see, as of now, I only have numbers.cs. I don't have exe file. The moment I compile it, it will create an exe file. See, now it is compiling now. So why I'm not getting here, source file could not be found. Okay, what I need to do is, I need to give I don't have numbers.cs inside this path, C users Meghnad, but where is this numbers.cs? I have it in D drive H2K. So what I need to do is, I need to go to D drive. So D drive, and then I need to go to CD. If I want to go to that folder, I have to go CD H2K. Now I need to give the same command. If you want to get the same command without typing again, what you need to do is, you can press up arrow mark. See, now I'm getting this. So all the previous commands I'll get using up arrow or down arrow. So now I got this. Now if I press enter, it is compiling. After compiling, you can see that numbers.exe has been created. Now to execute that, what you need to do is, you need to type numbers that will execute. Okay, now the reason why I gave full path is in case if you have not added this in your environment variables, if you have not added in environmental variables, when you type CSC, it will show you unrecognized command. So all you need, you have to copy this path and add that path there, then you can type CSC. But if you give full path, you don't need to configure in environmental variables. You can just give this full path. So you can completely type the path of CSC, which is this, and then you can give numbers.cs. Okay, that is the reason why we are giving full path. Okay, so now I have one more question. So when you type something, for example, I'll tell you one more thing. When you added this in environmental variables, when you type CSC, that started working. So now how to open a calculator? If I want to open a calculator, so how to open it? I can simply write Windows R and I can type calculator, CALC. So where do you think this calculator is there? Anyone knows where do you think this calculator is there? Any answer? Where do you think this calculator is there? How it is able to pick up when I type Windows R calc? So it is not there in operating system. Actually, all these files are stored somewhere. So see, now when I go to my computer, C:, and when I go to Windows inside system, inside I guess system, where is system? Yeah, here, Windows system 32, here we need to have calculator. So let's verify whether we have calculator or not. So modify by arrange by type, and then let's see whether we have calculator or not. Do we have calculator here? A B C D E M N O P. So I need to go to the top. So still top. Yeah. Do you have this calculator here? So when I double click on it, you can open the calculator. Okay. So what they have done is they have added all the exe files here, and then they copied this path. They copied this path, and they have added in environmental variables. So the moment you copy this path in environment variables, whatever file exe file you have here, you can open it directly from the Windows R. You can open like this CALC. So it'll open calculator. So I have a question. So now I have my exe file here. So where is my exe file? I have my exe file numbers.exe. So when I click on it, when I execute it, what is the output I'm getting? I'm getting as numbers. I'm getting as 5. So now if I type here, see now Windows R CMD. So if I type here CALC, what will happen? If I type CALC, do you think this will open calculator? Answers. Do you think this will open calculator? Yeah, it will open calculator. See now, the moment I press enter, it is opening calculator. Even from the command prompt, it is opening calculator because they have configured the path in environmental variables. So now, if I type numbers, do you think I'll get 5? If I type numbers here, do you think I'll get 5? See now, I have this output A is equal to 5. And if I type here numbers, do you think I'll get 5? Why I'll not get 5? I'm getting response saying no, because my exe file numbers is not present in this folder. It is in different folder. So if I press here, it'll tell no. So in that case, what I can do is, if this numbers to be executed in all the places, what I need to do is I simply need to copy this I need to copy this. Either I need to change the drive or I can copy this and go to my computer, right click on this, properties, advanced system settings, like how we did yesterday. I'm going to add this path. So go to path and click on edit, and at the end put a semicolon and paste it, and then click okay. So now let me close it. Let me type Windows R CMD. Now let me type numbers. Do you think this will work? This should work. So let me type numbers. See, I'm getting 5. So that is how your calculator is working, because your calculator path is configured in environmental variables. The moment you type calculator, it will search for all the paths mentioned in the environmental variables. Then if it is found, it'll open the calculator. So now also, even though my numbers is in different drive, so I'm typing numbers here. Ideally, I should type it inside my D drive H2K. But even I'm typing in C users Meghna, even now numbers is getting executed because I have added this in environmental variables. Okay. I think this is not required to discuss, but I just thought of giving you some information. Okay. So now, if you see here, either you can declare this as int a is equal to 5, or you can declare this. There is other name for this, which is int. So for integer, how many bits are required? For integer, how many bits? Integer data type, how many bits? Integer data types, I'm asking in bits, not bytes, bits. So it is actually 32 bits. So if I write like this, so I'm seeing few responses. So okay. So now I can even declare int a, I can even declare like int 32a. So this is alias for integer, or you can say integer is alias for this. So if I'm very new to programming, if I don't know what is a 16-bit data type for integers, 16-bit data type for integers, what is the data type which will have 16 bits? It is U short, or it is short, both take 16 bits. So if I'm very new to .NET programming, I don't know what is the data type for 16 bit, I don't need to remember all those things. For that purpose, .NET framework has come up with something like which you can remember easily. So in 32 you can declare like this, and let me save it, and you can compile it. So let me compile it. So I need to go to D drive, I need to go to CD H2K, okay, and then CSC space numbers.cs, and then I'll type numbers. So even then it is working. So if somebody asks you int 32 and int, both are alias, okay, and if you put U int 32, that means this is for which data type? This is for uint. So now similarly we have something called int 16. Can you guess what is for which data type we have int 16? Correct. Which data type? Int 16 is for which data type? It is for short or U short? It is for short. It is for short. Because I'm not mentioning uint 16. Okay, so if I mention uint 16, then it is for short, U short. If I mention int 16, that is for short data type. Okay, similarly, if I mention int 64, can you tell me for which data type is this? Yeah, it is for long. I am saying some, yeah, it is for long. So now we don't have int 8, so the designers has not given int 8. So int 8 is for which one we are expecting? Int 8, yeah, but we don't have int 8 for byte. So they have given the name as byte only. So it is this one, BYTE. So BYTE, capital byte, capital BYTE is the short form of small byte. Okay, so let's go back and verify these things here in the PDF document. So the system type name for integer is int32. Either you can declare as int32 or just integer. For long it is int64. For byte it is capital byte. For uSHORT it is uint16. For uint it is uint32. For uLong it is uint64. So now for sbyte, again it is capital sbyte. So you might think like, why for sbyte they have added this? They could have added int8, and for byte they could have added uint8, but they have decided like this. So we have to remember. Okay, so now quick questions you need to answer me. What is the system type name for integer? Yeah, int32, right? So you need to be very very clear while typing. I is capital and there is no space between int and 32, so it is int32. Okay, so now next question, what is the system type for sbyte? What is the system type for sbyte? Yeah, for sbyte the system type is sbyte, capital sbyte. For byte the system type is BYTE, byte. Okay, so the last question, what is the system type for long? Yeah, for long the system type is int64, because long takes 8 bytes, so it is int64. Okay, so someone wants to have this, so let me copy this. So anyway, I'll try to share this as well with you. So as I said before, just drop a test email. I'll again validate this email IDs with H2K. Okay, so anyway, I'll be getting email ID list from my H2K team, and I'll be sharing this content as well. Okay, so now this is about, yeah, sure, Sri, I'll send this. Yeah, so this is about data types for integers. Okay, integers. So what if I want to store 1.5, 2.5, like that? See, now if I type here 5.5 or something, a byte cannot store 5.5. it only stores integers, like only 5 it can store. But if you want to store decimal numbers like 5.5 or 6.2356 or something like that, you have to go for other data types. For that we have these other data types. We have float, double, decimal. So these three are used for storing fraction values also, like 2.5, 3.5, like this. So depending on the accuracy, so if you want to go for more accuracy, you have to go for decimal. For example, if I want 2.56, then I'll go for float. If I want to go for 2.567923, like that, then I'll go for double. Up to, so if I want very very accurate, like 0.00, like size of proton, size of neutron, maybe in physics you have discussed it is 0.00000 or 5 mm or something like that, in that case we'll go for decimal. So the more accuracy you need, you have to go for the decimal. So these are the data types which you have for storing decimal values: float, double, decimal. So here that the system type names for float is single. You have to recollect it is not system.float, it is system.single. So single, and this is double, and for this it is decimal. Okay, and we have bool. Bool is used to store true or false. So boolean or bool is used to store true or false, and the system name is boolean. System type name is boolean. And the next one we have is character, char data type, and it will store characters like A, B, C, D, or any character it will store, and that is character. So you should remember the size for character. So the size for character data type is 2 bytes. Okay, and the last one, string, the system name is string string. Here it is small letter, it's a typo here. So small letter string, and the system name is capital string. Okay, so now can you type what are the data types we have for storing fractional values or decimal numbers? Can you type the three data types which we have for storing decimal numbers? Float, double, and what is the next one? Float, double, and decimal. Okay, float, double, and decimal. So don't get confused with this name and this name. Float and single both are same. I'm seeing people typing float, comma, single, comma, double. So float and single both are same. This is just an alias name for this. Okay, so now what is the size of char data type? It is 2 bytes. Okay, we have it here. So for storing strings, for example, if I want to store my name, I'll store like this: string name is equal to Meghnad. Inside double quotes I need to store. Okay, but if you want to store numbers, you don't need to give double quotes. Int A is equal to 5. Okay, so keep this in mind. If you want to assign any value for an integer or any other data type, you just need to give assign like this. But for strings, you have to assign in double quotes. Okay, for characters, okay, so now let me try to print it. Remember, the data type string is S small letter. So now if I type it here, so if I want to print my name, I need to give like this. So let me save it. Now let me compile it. So how do we compile it? CSC space numbers.cs. Now numbers. See, now it is printing my name, Meghnad. So for storing strings, the data type is string. So now if I make it capital S, do you think this will work? If I make this small s to capital S, do you think that will work? That should work, because what is for small string, what is the system type? Capital string. Okay, ideally C sharp is case sensitive, but in this case, see now, if I ask you a question like this, for example, if I ask a question like this, int a is equal to 5. If I write like this, console dot write line a, so if I compile this, I saved it, and then once I save it, I need to compile, otherwise I'll get the previous output. See now, if I type numbers, I'm getting Meghnad. So once I save it, I have to compile it, otherwise the previous exe file will execute. So now I will compile it. Now when I type numbers, I'm getting output. So now if I change this integer to int 32, do you think this will work? Yes, this will work, because int 32 is just an alias name, or int 32 and int both are same. Similarly, if I have written like this, small string name is equal to Meghnad, and now if I write name, if I change a small string to capital string, that will work, because system type name for small string is capital string. So now if I make this to capital S, do you think this will work? Yeah, it will work. Okay, so let's go and okay, so I'll do one thing. What I'll do now is, see, now lot of times they would have asked in interviews, so see now what is the, I'll just show you what is the difference between lot of times in interviews people will ask this question, even so let's see what is the difference between capital string and small string, what is the difference between string and string, what is the difference, see now how many times they have asked in how many times they have asked in, so what is the difference, can you tell what is the difference? Yeah, both are same. So string is a system type and both are same, it is just alias names. So see now, let's see what is the response they are giving. Let's verify that. So if someone asks you in the interview, don't get confused. Capital string and is different. So in .NET framework, at least C# language, we have two versions of string type. One is capital string and a small string. So what is the difference? So string is an alias for string in .NET framework. So see now, you're getting it now. So there is no difference. String, small string is an alias name for capital string. Okay, so both are same. They both are same. There is no difference. They are same thing. String is just alias for capital string. Okay, so now. Okay, so with this, we'll go to now. Let me ask questions. Okay, can you tell me what is the system type for float? Yeah, very good. So remember, C# is case sensitive. System type for float is not system dot float. System type for float is system dot single. Okay, so I'll show you. That is the purpose. That is the reason why I asked. Even I had some confusion when I'm learning .NET. So system type for float is system dot single. It is not system dot float. Okay, and another question, let me ask another question. So what is the system type for bool? What is the system type for bool? Yeah, I got correct. So it is boolean. It is boolean, and remember it is case sensitive, so you have to give boolean. Okay, so now with this, what we can actually go to the next one, which is operators. Okay, for strings alone, I'm not going to discuss now. Strings I will discuss in value types and reference types. So I'm not going to touch anything about strings now. I'll discuss this later. Okay, so strings and yeah, okay. So now strings alone is a very, very big topic, so we are going to dedicate half an hour for it, so not now. Okay, so now coming to this, we have operators. So now we are going to learn about operators. So okay, so let's get started with operators. So we'll take 5 minutes logical break, or we'll continue, or we'll stop here. So feel free. So okay, so I'm getting response from only few people. So shall we continue, or we'll take a break, or we'll stop here for today? Okay, so I'm seeing mixed responses. So Friday night, please stop. Okay, so are you able to see the chat window? I mean, my chat window, you're able to see? Okay, good. You're able to see my chat window, like your responses which I'm seeing? Yeah, okay, good. Okay, so now, so what we'll do is we will stop here for today. Normally I wanted to take for 2 hours, but still we just started with the course. So what we can do is for today, what you do is tomorrow and day after tomorrow, please go through the these videos. So let me stop recording. Just a second.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.